Hey guys, welcome back to the video. As I said you in the last video, the next video we are going to do the AI mouse. Now as you can see in the screen right here, I'm able to control this mouse with the help of my hand or my finger right here. Now if you guys have not seen the previous video, I will leave the link in the description. You guys can go check it out. And that video is very important guys, because if we have to build this AI mouse, we need that a package or the Python package or the Python file which you have created in the previous video. So I will leave the link in the description. You guys can go check it out, or there'll be an I button right here in the top. You guys can check it out right here. So go check it out and then come to this video. So talking about the features about this AI mouse, this AI mouse can open any of the tabs right here, or it can open this image right here, or any window in Chrome, or any software or application that is available on the desktop or any device. Now talking about this image, I can open this image, so let me show you the demo of this. So I'll double click right here, it's loading, and if you give it a little bit time, and here you go, the image is right here, the AI virtual assistant. Now if I want to zoom into this AI virtual assistant, I have to come right here, double click, and you can see the AI virtual. Now I have to zoom out, I can again do this and I'll zoom out, and if I want to zoom in here, I'll double click right here and zoom in, and again double click, that's it. So if I bring my two, this middle finger and this index finger right here, and there you go, double tap, double tap, that's it. So this is the feature about this AI mouse. And if I want to see my own video and any of the web browsers, so suppose I want to see my YouTube video, so I'll come right here down below. If I come right here, here is my YouTube channel, and if I want to watch my own video right here, I'll just click on this, and it'll take a little bit of time to load, and I will be able to watch my own video. Now, I'm not sure if there's going to be an ad. If there's going to be an ad, I'm going to skip it.
Hey guys, welcome back to the video.
So if you see right here, my video is right here. So this is how AI mouse works. Now let me remove this right here. If I go right here, and if I remove, yeah, there you go, it has been removed. So today we are going to do this AI mouse with the help of the hand and my finger. I'm able to move my mouse, and you guys will also be able to move your mouse with the help of your hand and your finger right here. So without wasting more time guys, let's get straight into the video. Now guys, I'm in my PyCharm file right here, or PyCharm. As you can see, this is the Py module, the hand tracking module right here. Now if you have not seen the previous video I told you last time, I will leave the link in the description. Go check it out. First see that video, write this program, and then come to this video, then only it's possible. Now at the last video, this part of this code from diff main, I had put this in the description, right? So only this part of the code is available in the description. Now for the rest of the whole part of this code, the source code of this, I will bring the source code in the description of this video. But to access the source code, I'm going to make a separate video for it, because there is a problem for putting the source code in the YouTube description. So there's an issue to put the code in the description. That's why I'm not able to put it like, you know, usually how I put it in the description, like this diff main I was able to put, but later on I was not able to put the whole source code. So that was an issue right there. So I'll bring a separate video on how to access the source code. So you guys can check it out later on. For that, make sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video also if possible, if you liked it. Stay tuned, because I'm going to bring very soon about how to access the source code. So if not, just watch the video. You guys just watch the video and write the code, that is also possible. But if you are a little bit lazy like me, if you want to just copy and paste it, just wait for a few more days and you will get to know how to access the source code. Now for today's video, what are we going to do? Very simple. Now with the help of this file, we are going to code. So very simple, we are going to right click on this, we are going to come right here, we are going to click on new right here, and we are going to put Python file. Now what Python file? We are going to put it as AI mouse, and I think that's fine, AI mouse, and if I want, I'll put some number right here, or let me put VP, yeah, because it's Vignesh Prasad, so I'll put it as VP. It's up to you, whatever name you want to keep it, it's up to you. So I'll click on enter, and once I click on enter, I'll close this, and AI mouse VP is, or AI mouse file is, has been created. Now we have to import certain file. Now first let's import CV2, because CV2 is the main CV2. We are going to import CV2. Once CV2 is imported, we are going to import AutoPy. Now the people who have faced problem how to install AutoPy and MediaPy have already done a video. If you have not checked it out, I will leave the link in the description. Go check it out, or there'll be an I button right here top somewhere. Click on that. Go watch the video how to install AutoPy, and also watch the previous video, the Python file, make the file, and then come to this video. Because if you come directly to this video, there's going to be a problem of installing this package, and you will not have hand tracking module package. So if you don't want that, just do this. Okay, so AutoPy has been imported. Then let's import time. Now you need not put as pip install time, as I told you in the last video, because it's already there in your device, whatever device is yours. We'll click enter. Then after importing time, let's import NumPy. Now NumPy comes with CV2, or CV2 comes with NumPy, however you call it as. So you did not put it as pip install NumPy. But if at all you are getting an error that NumPy has not been installed, it has not been installed, click on the terminal right here. Come to terminal, click right here, put pip install terminal, pip install NumPy, and you will be able to install it. But after importing the package right here, after importing NumPy, we are going to put it as NumPy as NP. Okay, let's put it as NP. Now once this is done, what we're going to do is we're going to import our Py hand tracking module. Now you will be wondering how to import. It's very simple, just put it as py, and as you can see right here, it has come. Just click on this and click enter. That's it, very simple. And this we are going to put it as htm. Now don't put html, it's going to give you error. Just put htm. Okay, html is a different thing. Okay, it's a short form of Py hand tracking module. Okay, now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to define called as the width cam and the height cam. Okay, so let's keep it as wh. Okay, let's keep it as wh cam. Okay, C capital is let's put both the wh cam and hh cam. Okay, hh cam and the wh cam. And we are going to define this is equal to, I will put 640. It's up to you guys how you want it. I'll put as 640 and 480. I will believe this is the default version. I kept it as default. If you want, just keep the same thing. Okay, now once this is done, what we are going to do, we are going to bring in the frame rate. Okay, we'll bring the frame rate. So we'll put frame R. I forgot to put the E right here. Frame R and is equal to, we'll bring the is equal to, and frame rate, let's keep it 100. There's nothing like your choice or anything. It's frame rate is equal to 100. Now once frame rate is done, what we're going to do is smoothening. So for smoothening, now this again depends on you. You can put smoothening as 5 is equal to 5, or you can put it as 6, or you can put it 7, or you can put 8. Totally up to you, but I will put it as 7. If you want to put it as 7, put it, not an issue. Now once this is done, we are going to do something called as the P time. Now what is P time? Present time. That's it, simple. Okay, so P time, and after P time we are going to bring 0, enter. Okay, and now we are going to bring the P lock. You will bring the P lock. P lock X, comma, and P lock Y also. P lock Y also we bring. So PLOC and then Y is equal to, after this is done, did I put K right there? I put the K right here. I'll remove the K right here and I'll come right here. Now PLOC X is there, PLOC Y is there. So we'll put it as 0, 0, did I again put the dot? No, 0. Okay, now once this is done, click enter. Now don't worry about this error, not the white thing, it stays like that. Don't worry about that PLOC and this PLOC Y. And apart from that, what we're going to do is going to put as the CLOC. Okay, now what is PLOC, CLOC, all these things? It is the present lock and present lock X, and this is, so we have to put CLOC Y, right? CLOC Y. Okay, wait, I'm not put correct. Yeah, CLOC Y is equal to again 0, 0. Right? Now I think we'll just separate this. Okay, let's separate this by hashtags. I separated this and I'll enter this and separate this. Okay. Now once this is separated, this is done. This is also done. Now PTAM is done. Now once this is done, we are going to bring the video capture. Now this is the important one, because we have to on our, we can't on the camera. Means we can go right here to the search one and put camera and on that, but that does not work. We have to open it through our Python, this folder or this file, PyCharm. So what we are going to do is we are going to put as camp is equal to cv2 with the help of cv2 dot, we are going to bring the video capture. Now if you remember, I think we have used this video capture in our previous video also. If you have not seen, go check it out again, and I'm telling you. So zero, once that is done, click enter. Now this is done. Now we are going to put it as cap set. We are going to set the cap. So we are going to put it as dot set and then open brackets. Once open brackets is done, put 3, and then we are going to bring the WH cam, the width cam, and then we are going to bring cam cap dot set. Again we are going to bring the set, and then we are going to open the brackets and 4. Now what is this 3, what is this 4? It's basically we are, you know, adjusting the length of the, now use in the beginning you saw the video of my camera, right? So that's basically we are just adjusting the height of it. It's going to be the same for everyone, so just put it 3 and 4. It does not matter, it does not differ for anyone. So we are going to bring the HH cam. Once HH cam is done, we are going to do something called as detector. Now what is this detector? And you'll be thinking, this detector we have already done. Yes, we have already done right here, detector, hand detector, everything the same thing. It's the same thing. Now detector, we are bringing the detector with the help of HTM. Fine. Now we are going to bring detector. We'll tell detector to come here. Detector, come to this file now and help us make the AI mouse. That's it. So we are going to put it as HTM. Okay, HTM dot hand detector. See, it came right here. Okay, detector is equal to HTM dot hand detector. And what we are going to do is we are going to bring the brackets and we are going to put it as max hands. Now if you have not remember, you know, you don't remember what max hands is, I will show you in very soon. I show you. So you remember this right here, max hands, and we did something right here, max hands also right here. The same thing we have done it here, max hand. Max hand is basically the maximum hands that it should track. So one hand, it's going to track only one hand. It's not going to track anyone other's hand, or anyone else is coming into your screen and showing his hand. It's not going to track. It's going to track only your hand. Now there are possibility that other's hands also are going to get tracked, because this is not, you know, a very high class generation software. It's just a normal program, so it's going to track, it is a rare case, but maximum is going to track one hand. That's, I'm going to assure you that. Now once this is done, what we're going to do is we're going to put as WS capital, okay, CR, okay. And now what is WS capital CR? screen, W screen, width of the screen, W screen, okay? And H, the same thing, S capital C R, okay? That is done, is equal to. Now what are we going to do is we are going to bring auto pi here, right? We are going to bring the auto pi, this the and the Python symbol right here, that one, the auto pi, and we are going to put dot, we are going to bring right here screen, okay, and dot size, that's it. Now once this is done, what you are going to do is you are going to click enter again, and we are going to bring the while true now, the while loop, okay? So we are going to bring the while loop. Okay, I think there should be a space right here. No, that should be fine. Now we're going to bring the while loop, or the while true, whatever you want to call it as. While true is equal to the two dots, and then now we are going to do a success pattern. So we are telling the device that you can access the camera, or it you can go ahead with it, so that our hand can be tracked. So success. Now don't worry if it is red, it's giving you error, it will show you, but it's fine. Success comma image is equal to, we're going to bring cap now, dot read, okay, read, and then what we're going to do is image right here is equal to detector, okay, detector dot find hands. Now here's find hands right here, find hands, and then you're going to put the image right here. Now where did this find hand come from? The find hand came from this right here, find hand we have defined right here, okay, this one we have defined here. Now I want to give you a small information. Now once this AI mouse is done, right, we are going to bring another video where we are going to connect our AI mouse to our virtual assistant. Yes, we are going to connect our virtual assistant to the AI mouse. It's very simple. If we say our virtual assistant, for example, Alexa, open AI mouse, it's going to go by charm, open AI mouse, and you can access the, you know, not access, you can move your mouse with the help of your hand. It's basically like you'll get the Iron Man feeling, right? So you get that Iron Man feeling, so the same way. So that's what we're going to do in the upcoming videos, and there is a surprise or something new coming into our channel. I'm not going to tell in this video, but definitely there's going to be a video on that. We are going to bring something new in our channel, so stay tuned for that. So make sure to subscribe to the channel. Now let's get back. Now once we have put this image right here, we'll put the LM list. You remember LM list? Our LM brother is here, LM list, and then comma, and then we are going to bring the B box. Now where is this B box? Where we have not defined? Why is it showing error? No, we are going to define, so wait for it. So we are going to put the detector, we are going to bring in detector, please come here, and then we are going to put it as find position, okay, find position this time, and click enter. Now where is find position? Again, I'm telling you, it's right here, okay? So for that, make sure to go check out the previous video, and then image right here, and then click enter. Now once this is done, we are going to do something like the if statement. Now in the previous video also we did the if statement, and for today's video also we are going to do the if statement. Now if you're talking about the source code of this file also, I'm going to bring the source code of this as well as the hand tracking, you guys can access it. So you need to wait for few more days and you will get to know how to access the source code, so stay tuned for that. So in order for that, subscribe to the channel, okay? So now let's get back again right here. Now we are going to put it as if, okay, if len, and then we are going to bring the brackets lm, and then we are going to bring the list. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to bring this symbol right here, and sorry I forgot the symbol name, sorry for that, and we are going to bring the, I think it's the exclamatory mark, something like that, I totally forgot, okay, sorry for that, I apologize. Okay, and we are going to bring is equal to 0, and then two dots, okay, two dots, and click enter. Now what are you going to do right here? We are defining x value, y value. So we are going to bring x1 and we are going to bring y1, like just like the previous video, x1 and y1. So once this is run, lm list, open the big brackets, and we are going to bring 8. Fine. Once 8 is done, then we are going to bring the two dots right here. Okay, not the two dots right here. The two dots will come right here inside this. So we are going to put 1 and then the two dots. Fine. Right here. Okay. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to come out of this box and we are going to click enter. Now again we are going to do x2, y2. Now we require this x2 and y2 later on, so that's why we are defining right now itself. Again we are going to bring the lm list, then again the big brackets. Now this is going to be 12, and next it's going to be again it's going to be big brackets, and we are going to put 1. Fine, that's it. Okay, sorry, yeah, this one. Now once this is done, click enter. Now next what we are going to do is we are going to do fingers. Now fingers is required because if you saw in the beginning, I was able to move the mouse with the help of my fingers, and yeah, basically my fingers, the most of the work was with the help of the fingers. So right now we are going to define the fingers. If you have not seen the previous video, if you have not observed properly, we did something called as fingers right here, if you remember this. So with the help of this, we are going to control the AI mouse. That's why in the previous video I kept on telling that this fingers up or the fingers thing is required, this is required again and again. So that's why, go watch it if you have not watched it again. And that's why I'm telling you guys again and again, go watch it, because when I did it, I got error because I had not done it properly, and I don't want the same thing to happen to you guys. So that's why I'm telling you again and again, go watch it. So there'll be no error for you. But if at all there's an error, please do let me know in the comment section. I will respond to you. Even in that AutoPie installation, there were many people who responded to me. I responded them to responded them back. They were able to install. So any kind of error, any kind of problem, do let me know. Now once this fingers is equal to is done, now what we're going to bring is we're going to bring the detector we have got. Now what we are going to do is we're going to bring the fingers up, as I told you previous just a second ago. And once this is done, click enter, and then we're going to bring the CV2. We're going to bring CV2. Let me come a little bit down. So yeah, CV2, and we'll put rectangle, and we'll put, okay, wait, the brackets already came, sorry, image. Once image is done, we'll put comma, we'll put another brackets, we'll put the frame R. If you remember frame R, frame rate, we did it right here, frame rate, that has been put right here, frame rate comma frame rate. Once this is done, come right here, put comma, and then again we are going to bring the brackets, and then the WH cam. If you remember, we did top right here, WH cam comma and HH cam and WH cam. The WH cam minus frame rate, okay, frame rate or frame R, and we are going to put comma now, and then we'll put the HH cam, and we're going to minus frame rate R. Now what are you going, you're asking me what are we doing? Yes, do the coding, you will get to know what I'm doing. This is basically adjusting the frame rate, as I told you, frame rate, you're adjusting it. Now once this is done, we are going to put comma, and we'll click enter, the brackets will go down, and then again we'll open a brackets, and now we're going to bring 255. 255 is comma or 0, 255. Okay, and then again we're going to come outside, we're going to put comma right here, and then we are going to bring 2. That's it. Now this is done. What we're going to do next is we're going to click enter. Once we click enter, we are going to bring in another if statement right here. We're going to put if fingers. Now we are going to define the fingers. Now this is the important part of the video. I'm going to make a frame right here in the video so that you get to know this is the important one. So this is the important one, or there'll be an emoji right here or something that's going to let you know that this is the important part. So this is the important part. Fingers, big brackets, one. Okay, fingers, big brackets, one. We are going to bring is equal to. Just do what I'm doing. Fingers is equal to big brackets, one, is equal to, then one. Okay, you get it? Now once this is done, and then what we're going to put, we're going to and, and then again what we're going to do is we are going to bring fingers again. Fingers and the big bracket and two. Fine. Now if I've put your fingers, yes, I've put it as fingers right here, and here also it's going to be the fingers. Now I'll minimize this line. I think that will be fine. Okay, now once this is done, what we're going to do is we are going to again bring it is equal to, and we're going to bring a zero now. Okay, and the two dots. Once two dots are brought, we're going to click enter. Fine. And now what we are going to do is we are going to convert the coordinates. Now the coordinates we had done before, now we are just going to convert it. That's it, very simple. So how are we going to convert it? We are going to put it as h2, and you remember the h1 x2 and x1 and y2 and y1, that one, very simple. So comma y2 is equal to lm list. We are going to bring the lm list and big brackets and 12. Fine. Once that is done, what we are going to do is we are going to come right here. We are going to bring another big brackets and one, and then the two dots. Fine. And then we are going to click enter. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to give space, and then we are going to put fingers. Now your fingers will become fine because we are going to define it now. Fingers is equal to detector. Now see, the red mark went right here. Okay, detector dot fingers up. Okay, fingers up, and the brackets have already come. Enter. Now cv2, you're gonna bring cv2 dot let's bring rectangle. And I believe we can just copy this thing and paste it right here. Just copy this. It's the same thing. Control C. And remove the brackets right here. Control V. Simple. Yeah, it's the same thing. There's no change. It's fully the same. So you just copy it and paste it. That's it. Now, once this is done, we are going to do it for the index finger now. Index finger movement. So for the index finger, we are again going to bring the if statement. To bring the if statement, what we are going to do is we are going to bring if, okay, and then fingers and the big brackets one, okay, fingers big brackets one is equal to and one, and then, and I think it's the same thing, we can just copy this, but I don't think it's already done right, so we just write it off. Fingers, again fingers, and the big brackets two. Fine. Once this is done, we are going to put is equal to, and then the zero, and then the two dots, and click enter. Now again we are going to convert the coordinates right here. We are going to bring it into the usual form right here. For converting the coordinates, what we are going to do is we'll put the x3. We'll do one thing, we'll do the x3, or let us, you know, let's do one thing, let us, or this thing is there, right? You just control C, copy this. Okay, copy this one from, I'll let you know, from this thing is there, right? From this, or this, let it be this, or else I think this should be fine, because if this is there, Yeah, this will be fine. This will be fine. Rectangle, fingers. Yeah. What I'm saying is, let's do one thing. Now this thing is there, right? This whole thing, fingers dot detector from here. Just copy this, and remove this right now. Just remove this for right now. I'll just tell you. And then you're going to paste it again later on. So just remove for right now. And what we're going to do right now is we will put the x3, okay? X3 is equal to np dot np. Now what is np? NumPy. We have defined it already. Enter. It's loading right here. We are going to print enter and open x1 comma, and then we are going to bring the brackets again, then frame r. Now the video might be going a little bit longer, I apologize for that, but for the AI mouse we require this, okay? So just stay with me and you will get to know what we are doing. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to put again the WH cam right here, and then what we are going to do is we are going to put minus and then frame rate again. Fine. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to bring the comma. Once comma is done, what we are going to do is we are going to put 0 and then comma WSCR, that is width, screen width, okay, which we have done before. Now once this is done, again click enter and do one thing, just copy this whole thing, Control C, and then come right here, Control V, and what you need to do is just put this is as Y3 and this one is Y1 and this frame rate, and here HH cam, and once that is done, you are going to put here H screen. Okay, now once this is done, what you are going to do is we are going to smoothen the value. To smoothen the value, what you are going to do is, if you remember, we did something called as C lock and the Y lock, correct? The same thing what we are going to do is we are going to bring it right here, the C lock and the Y lock. Okay, so to do that, what we'll do is, first let me come right here. Oh, let me just check this. If fingers, so yeah, one, this should be fine. Before that, this is the thing. So right here I made a small mistake. If you have not noticed it, you have to put as S, and now the red mark has gone. Okay, I did a small mistake right there, I apologize for that. I was just wondering why is this finger still red, because the fingers S was missing right here. That was the main reason. Okay, now once this is done, what we're going to do next is we'll bring the C lock right now. C lock X and is equal to, we'll put it as the P lock X. Okay, and then what we're going to do is we're going to bring the plus symbol and then the comma, and then we're going to bring X3 minus P-lock, okay, P-lock X actually, now it's not P-lock Y, now it's P-lock X. And once this is done, we are going to put slash right here, and then we are going to put smoothening. Now where is this smoothening coming from? If you remember, we had put smoothening right here, 7, okay, smoothening, that's it, very simple. Now once this is done, what I'll tell you is just copy this, okay, just do this, Control C. It'll make your work easier, okay? Because I keep on doing the same thing and you can also do it. So now we are going to bring C lock Y. Now copying pasting is actually a bad habit because you're not learning right there, but if you want to conserve the time, you want to save the time, you can just do Control C and Control V. It will reduce your time and everything. Now, once this is done, what you do is you're going to put here Y3, and once this is done, we are going to put P lock Y. Okay, Y, everything is Y. Okay, that's done. Now, smoothening is done. This is done, right? Now, try to just adjust this. Let's put space right there, and it will be fine. Now, once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to use AutoPie now, because AutoPie is important right now. So we are going to do is auto. What did I do? Okay, AutoPie. We are going to bring the AutoPie now. Click enter. Once AutoPie is done, what you're going to do is dot mouse. Okay, dot move, and then the big brackets. Okay, the brackets already came. The brackets. Normal brackets. W screen minus. Okay, minus C lock X. Okay, it's going to be C lock X, and then comma C lock Y. Just do this, C lock Y. Now this is done. What you're going to do next is you're going to click enter, and then if you remember in the beginning of the video, there was a circle when I was to bring the two fingers together, a green color circle. So to indicate that, we are going to do this right now. We are going to bring CV2 dot circle. We are going to bring the circle, and then we are going to bring image. Okay, click on image. Let me just remove this thing. And once image is done, what you're going to do is you're going to bring the comma, and then brackets again. Now, if you remember, there was an x1 comma y1 we had done before, so we are going to bring that. This thing is again and again disturbing me. Okay, now once this is done, comma 50. Okay, once that is done, again comma the brackets 255 comma 0 comma 255. Now what is this 15 255 0 255 is basically we are defining the color. Okay, so just copy it, you'll define the color. Now once this is done, put comma, and we are going to bring the CV2 dot filled. So where is the filled? Let's call the filled brother. Filled brother is here. Okay, so filled is done. What we are going to do next is we are going to click enter. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to classify the two fingers which come together. When the two fingers and when the index finger is going to the or moving the mouse, to classify that, we are going to do that now. So what we are going to do is we are going to click enter, and what we are going to do, we are going to bring an if statement again. Now this if statement should be there with this if. Okay, make sure you're not putting the if statement to the CV2, it should be right here. Okay, now once this is done, what you're going to do is this is the same statement, so just do one thing, copy this, Control C and paste it. Okay, once that is done, what you're going to do is you're going to click enter. Once you click enter, what you're going to do is you're going to put the length value right now. You're going to put the length, so it's not there, we are going to define it right now. Length image, so basic img, and then line info. Okay, line information basically it is. So line info, I'll keep the I capital right here. Info, line info is equal to detector dot find hands. Oh no, find distance. Where's find distance? Yeah, it's here. Find distance, and then 8 comma 12 comma image. Now we already classified this here also. If you remember, we did 8. Yeah, this one here. This one. So the same thing, we are doing it here. Now once this image has been put, what we are going to do next is we'll come here, and then what we'll do is we'll put we are going to print the length. Okay, let the length be print, because you will get to know if it's working or not working. So we are going to print the length. Once the length has been print, what you're going to do is, again we are going to bring the if statement. So put if and then length. What you're going to do is, you're going to come down and put this length, and we are going to bring this arrow mark towards the left side, and then what you're going to bring is 39. Now this you have to adjust by yourself. For me it is 39, for you it could be 40 or less than 39, like 35 or 36 or 37, up to you. You need to check it. Okay, so 39 and click enter, but you can keep it as default. And then again, do one thing, this circle we did, right, CV2 circle, copy this, Control C and Control V. Okay, once this is done, CV circle image. Now here what you have to do is, you have to change this. We are going to put line info. Okay, line, let this go. Oh yeah, line info. Did I do a mistake right here? Yeah, I did not put the E right here. I put it again, sorry. Yeah, line info. Yeah, this should be fine. Line info. Once line info has been put, we are going to bring the big brackets, 4. Fine, that is done. Now what you're going to do, you're going to put the comma, and once that is done, you're going to bring again line info. Let's call back line info again, big brackets, and then 5. And once that is done, come outside, and what you're going to do is, you're going to put 15. 15 is already there, 0 is there. Oh, let's do one thing, let's put this right here, 255. Oh, 0, and let's, no, we'll do one thing, we'll bring this back and we'll put the 15 down. Let's put the 15 down and let's give space right here. Yeah, this should be fine. Yeah, once this is done, now what we're going to do is, we are going to tell AutoPy to click. So tell AutoPy, you're going to call AutoPy, AutoPy come here, and then you're going to put dot mouse dot click. Okay, once that is done, brackets it will come automatically. Now this is done. Now this last, it's something like, you know, five lines to be put, and your AI mouse is done. Okay, your AI mouse is done with just 5 more lines, that's it. Now what you're going to do is, you're going to come down, and what you're going to do is, you're going to come down right here full, and sorry, what do you do, I'll undo the edit, I'll come right here, this did something wrong, undo typing. Okay, anyways, I'll bring it down right here. Okay, and then I'll click down, and then what I'm going to do is, what I'm going to do is, I'll put the C time. I'm going to bring the C time. Now what is the C time, what are we doing? We are going to tell the frame rate. Wow, it's going to show you the frame rate. Okay, so C time is equal to time dot, okay, and again time. Okay, C time is equal to time dot time brackets, simple. Now once this is done, what you're going to do is, we are going to click enter. Okay, what happened right here, click enter, and once that is done, what we're going to do is, we'll come to this FPS right here. We'll do the FPS. To do the FPS, what we are going to do is, we are going to, wait, did I put the time wrong? I think so, I put the time wrong, or else it would have not come. Let me just check. This should be, if I'm not wrong, this should be somewhere right. Let me just check. Yeah, this should be fine right here now. Yeah, it should be fine right here. Yes, this is fine. This is fine. I think now should be fine. Time. Yeah, this is time dot time and brackets. Done. Now we're going to come down, and we're going to put the FPS now. We're going to bring in the FPS. FPS is equal to 1. Okay. And then we're going to bring the slash, means basically divide it. Fine, give the paste right here. Once that is done, bring the brackets and then we'll put the seed type. Okay, and then we put the p time right here. Okay, once this is done, c time is done, p time is done, click down, click enter. And once that is done, what we are going to do is we are going to bring the p time right here. P time is equal to, and we are going to bring c time. Okay, now that is done. Now what we are going to do is we are going to put cv2 dot put text. Okay, we're going to put put text, and then we're going to put image, and then comma str string, and then we're going to bring init. Okay, and brackets and fps. Once this is done, we are going to come to the next, the second bracket, put comma, and this other bracket we are going to bring 40, 50. Fine. Once this is done, what we are going to do is we are again going to put the comma and cv2 dot, we are going to bring the font now. Okay, font Hashis plain. Yeah, this is fine. Yeah, this one, and again comma, and we are going to bring the 3. We are going to bring number 3, and then comma, and click enter. Once that is done, you are going to bring another bracket, and you are going to bring 255, comma, 0, comma, 0. And once that is done, what you are going to do is you are going to put comma and 3. Now, once this is done, what you're going to do is gonna click enter, and you're going to put cv2 dot image show, image show, and you're going to bring in the double columns and I capital and image right here. And once that is done, we're going to come outside, put the comma, and again image. Fine, that is done. What you're going to do, you're going to click enter, and once that is done, you're going to put cv2 again dot weight key. We'll put the weight key, and we're going to put it as 1. And there you go, your AI mouse has been created. This is your AI mouse code. Now the source code, I'll bring it very soon, so you guys can get the source code. Now the AI mouse has been created. If you want, actually you can run the file only if you want, like if you want to check it, I think it'll work. Yeah, this is basically the AI mouse. We have done the AI mouse right here, and the next video we are going to connect this AI mouse to our virtual assistant. So you just say virtual assistant, run AI mouse, or open AI mouse, or play AI mouse. It's going to open AI mouse, and you can, you know, with the help of your hand, you're able to control your mouse. It's like that Iron Man kind of a feel, like it was in, I think it was in Iron Man 2 or Iron Man 1, I'm not sure, but it was in one of that. I think it's Iron Man 2. He was able to control it, the whole screen, with the help of his hand. So something like that. So if you want, you can just, you know, click enter right here, click right, and click on run AI mouse VP. If I click right here, the terminal is going to open, and let's check if any error is there or anything. We'll get to know. There is the screen, and if I come right here, you can move the whole thing right here. So that's how it works. So there is your AI mouse. Your hand is being tracked. So that's how AI mouse works. I'll remove right now. I'll remove this. I'll remove the terminal. So that's how the AI mouse works. So I'll leave the link of the previous video in the description, and the source code will be available very soon. Just wait for a few more days, you'll get to know. And the surprise thingy, or the something new that's going to come to our channel, is also you're going to get to know very soon. So stay tuned for that. If you like the video, or you are able to understand the video, make sure to like the video, subscribe to our channel first subscribe to the channel and smash that notification and keep that notification on so that you'll get to know when the next video is coming. So that's it for today's video, guys. I don't want to elaborate it more and make the video a little bit more longer. I hope I have not taken much of the time to explain few stuff, but if I have, I apologize for that. So that's it. Thank you guys for watching till here. See you guys in the next video. Till then, take care. Have a great day and bye.